To all of our satellite viewers, my name is Minister Carla Goshton, and I bring you greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus from the Who Told You Show. The Who Told You Show is founded by Dr. Marjorie Wilson. Our weekly broadcast is viewed across the airwave via Bell Global, broadcasting every Sunday morning from 10:30 a.m. until 11 o'clock. You can also Google us at bgntvgospel.com, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. How about that? Amen. God bless you. I just want to start out by saying on today, to get excited, to tell the TV viewers on today to get excited. Hallelujah, about the communion of the Holy Spirit. Isn't it such an awesome and wonderful, wonderful thing how the Holy Spirit can come and visit us, amen, in our places of where we occupy, in our homes, our jobs, and even in our car, amen, to have the Holy Spirit come and visit us and just give us a word of encouragement or a word of direction or a word of instruction, amen. So get excited about the work of the Holy Spirit that comes into our midst, hallelujah, to dwell with us, hallelujah, glory to God, that the Lord, amen, can lead and direct our path. Amen. Hallelujah. Stay excited about that. It's a wonderful, wonderful experience. It's just so exciting. You know, there was a time where I wasn't in communion with the Holy Spirit and I didn't have the Holy Spirit there working for me. So it's just such a blessing. Amen. Glory to God. So get excited and stay excited about that. I'm telling you, when God just comes in through the Holy Spirit and just says one word, it's a big deal. It's major. Glory to God. Amen. That one word, hallelujah, could cause us to fall in line and fall into alignment, hallelujah, at that time as to what he has for us. So it's so important to just stay on fire for that. Stay, amen, excited about that. Glory to God. Whatever comes our way, hallelujah, the Holy Spirit is there. He's there to help us. He's there to lead us. He's there to guide us. He's there to comfort us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So get excited and stay excited about that. Stay stirred up about that. Amen. As a word of inspiration, the Lord said to me to tell the people, amen, that he meant just what he said when he said it. Amen. Let me say that one more time. He said to tell you that he meant just what he said when he said it. Glory to God. The Bible lets us know that God is not a man that he could lie. He can't fail us. Hallelujah. He's not the son of man that he should repent. So exactly what God said and when he said it. He meant it. Amen. Hallelujah. So I just want to inspire you today. You know, God knew the course of action that would take place. Amen. Between the prophecy and the promise, between the prophecy and the manifestation. He knew the course of action when he said it. Amen. So just be encouraged to stand upon what God has said to you, what he has spoken. Keep on believing and trusting in God and keep on obeying him. Amen. Hallelujah. Stay on course. God meant it. He said it and he shall perform it. He sent word on today. He meant exactly what he said when he said it. Glory to God. I got so excited about that word from the Lord. I'm telling you, sometimes the cares of this world try to come and bring doubt, and sometimes the things, the struggles and the things that happen try to weigh us down and want us to give up on God and throw in the towel, but the devil is a lie. God said he meant exactly what he said when he said it, and he means it today. Amen. But I want to serve you. Notice that there is a requirement. The Lord asks us to obey. Obey him. Obey when he comes, amen, to commune with us. Obey, amen, when he comes to teach us and guide us and direct our path. Hear the word of the Lord. Hear the voice of God. Hear him on today. Amen. Because he's right there and he's speaking. He's speaking right there in your midst. He's speaking right there in your living room. He's speaking right there on your job. He's speaking right there in your vehicle. He's speaking right there. Amen. Be obedient. Because the Bible lets us know that obedience is better than the sacrifice. Amen. But just a word of encouragement. Hallelujah. God meant exactly what he said, just when he said it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And even the prophecy that was spoken, even the words that were said to you. Glory to God. Sometimes we have to go back and ask God. Amen. Give me a refreshing, Lord God. Let me know, Jesus, that I'm still waiting, Lord God, on the promise. Let me know that my waiting is not in vain. Let me know, Lord God, that you're still going to do just what you said. Let me know that you have not forgotten about me. Amen. I'm telling you, have that communion, have that relationship with him. Talk to him about it. Ask the Lord to remind you of the prophecy. Ask him to refresh the prophecy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. The Gospel of John in chapter 14, 26 says that the Comforter will come and he will remind us. Amen. The Comforter will come and he will teach us. He will lead us and he will guide us. Amen. So God is right there. Hallelujah. He is our help. Amen. Lift up your eyes unto him. He is our help. Hallelujah. Speak to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to God. We got to be willing to talk to him and wait for him to talk back to us. Amen. Hallelujah. So be inspired today that the Lord said, hallelujah, that he meant just what he said when he said it. Amen. So let us pray at this time. We're going to pray for the city of Detroit. Continue to pray for our great city. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we come, Father, to give thanks, Lord God, for your mercy and your grace, oh God. We come, God, to give thanks for your goodness. Lord God, we come to give thanks for the Holy Spirit that communes with us, Father, daily. We come, Lord God, hallelujah, Father, to lift you up and magnify your name, God, and bring glory to your name on today. Lord God, as we continue to pray for the city of Detroit, Lord God, we just thank you, Father, hallelujah, that things are changing, things are turning around, Lord God, for the good of the city, for the good of those, Lord God, hallelujah, that's there. Father, we just thank you now, Lord God, hallelujah, how you use people strategically, how you're strategically placing people in place, Lord God, hallelujah, that you have, Lord God, raised up for such a time as this, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, hallelujah, Father, for good reports in spite of what we see, in spite of what we hear. We thank you, Lord God, Father, that there's some awesome things that's happening in the atmosphere. There's some awesome things, Lord God, that's taking place in the realm of the spirit. There's some awesome things, Lord God, that's taking place in our midst, oh God, in the name of Jesus, Father, hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, I speak to the atmosphere of Detroit, Lord God, and I decree and declare now, Father, that the atmosphere of Detroit is blessed. I thank you, Lord God, that the atmosphere of Detroit is a safe haven. I thank you, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, that the atmosphere of Detroit is healed, Lord God, and delivered and set free in the mighty name of Jesus, God. I thank you that the atmosphere comes into alignment, Lord God, of your word, Father, hallelujah, Lord God, that says you are God of decency, you are God of order, hallelujah, Lord God, that you bring in the city of Detroit and this atmosphere, Lord God, into your divine order, your divine healing, Lord God, that you are healing that land, Father, Lord God, no matter what it looked like, Father, we thank you that you're doing a mighty work. We thank you, Lord God, for your mighty acts that's taking place there. We thank you, Lord God, that your miracle power, working power, God, is working throughout the city in the name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah. You're reversing. You're reversing, Lord God, everything, Lord God, that's not like you. You're reversing it, the curse. You're reversing it, God. You're redeeming us, Lord God, by your blood, Father. I just thank you now, Lord God, for the good reports. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, and how you're just wiping out the crime there, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, hallelujah, Lord God, how you're using people, Father, in great and mighty ways, Father, I just thank you now, Lord God, and we give you all praise, honor, and glory for it, Lord God, hallelujah, Father, that you have not forgotten about the city of Detroit, you have not forgotten about us, so God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, for your mighty acts and your mighty work, Lord God, your awesomeness that's taking place, Father, in the city of Detroit, in Jesus' mighty name, oh God. Father, I just thank you for this broadcast. Father, I thank you for blessing it. I thank you, Lord God, for every word that's spoken on the broadcast, oh Father, that is from you. I thank you, Lord Jesus, Lord God, for blessing the hearers, Lord God, of this word, Father, in Jesus' name, Father. Thank you, God. I give you praise, honor, and glory that you are magnified, lifted up. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My foundation is scripture, hallelujah, is found in the Gospel of Mark, hallelujah, chapter 16 and verse 17. Thank you, Jesus. And the Bible reads, "And these signs will accompany those who believe." Amen. Right there, glory to God, the Lord gave me the subject of God still has the power to perform a miracle for you. Amen. Hallelujah. And he says in his word that these signs and wonders shall follow them that believe. They shall accompany you. Hallelujah. So what is a miracle? A miracle is an event that appears unexplainable by the laws of nature. You know, those things that happen that we look at the situation and we look at and say, well, there's just no way that this should have came out of that. Glory to God, where the situation looks so impossible. Hallelujah. Now, according to the law of nature, it should have never happened. Hallelujah. So the miracle is that unexplained thing that supersedes the natural process of life. My God, and an event that excites, hallelujah, and admiring all. Glory to God. It is just simply an act of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I don't know about you. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm excited. Glory to God that God can still perform a miracle for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So get excited about his awesomeness. Get excited. Hallelujah. About his awesomeness against the law of nature. You know, the enemy wants us to focus, amen, on the natural things and the natural way of doing things. But the Bible lets us know that the Lord does not think like us. His thoughts are much higher than us. Amen. That's why it's so important to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. When he say move, move. When he say flow, flow. When he say go, go. Hallelujah. This is why it is so important. Hallelujah. To be obedient. Thank you, Jesus. If you want to experience the awesomeness, hallelujah, of his miracles, the awesomeness of his signs and his wonders, glory to God, hallelujah, you have to be obedient. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And also, the miracle is God's intervention in humanity. So he steps in. When God steps in for us, when we're faced with situations that occur, that we've done all we can do, we've stood, we've done all we know, hallelujah, God actually steps in and accomplished that victory for us. Amen. Hallelujah. So he wants you to know, to our satellite viewers, that he can still perform a miracle. You know, sometimes things look so grim and sometimes things look so impossible and we get so stuck on what's going on right there that the eyes can see, but there's some things that's going on that the naked eye cannot see. Hallelujah. And the Lord wants us, amen, to walk this thing by faith, because he's a God of supernatural. Hallelujah. And he works in the supernatural realm, hallelujah, of his power. God comes to encourage you today, hallelujah, and let you know, hallelujah, that he can still perform that miracle. He can still, hallelujah, work that thing out for you. He can still turn it around for you. Hallelujah. Don't give up on God. Hallelujah. He is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you can ask or think. Hallelujah. All that I can ask or think. Hallelujah. Just take your eyes off the situation. Hallelujah. And put your faith and your confidence. Hallelujah. In the power of God. Glory to Jesus. Amen. God performed miracles, hallelujah, to carry out his purpose or to reveal who he is. Amen. So when God performs a miracle, there's a purpose. Hallelujah. And not only that, he comes to reveal who he is. Hallelujah. God comes to touch somebody and cause somebody to believe. Hallelujah. And come into that confidence. Hallelujah. That he is true and that he is the living God and that he is alive. Hallelujah. And that we do have access to him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So God comes, hallelujah, to perform those miracles. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because he's trying to increase our faith. Increase our faith in him. He's trying to touch somebody in your midst. Hallelujah. He's trying to cause unbelievers to believe. Glory to God. He has a purpose. Thank you, Jesus. So when God performs a miracle, it's a wonder. It brings astonishment, a marvel. Hallelujah. He causes people to feel puzzled. Well, what just happened? Glory to God. Well, I didn't do that. Why did that happen? Hallelujah. What about God's miracle working power? Hallelujah. That stepped in for you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Signs are the existence of evidence of his presence. Glory to God. So God will send a sign. He will send a wonder. Hallelujah. Glory to God. As evidence that he lives. Hallelujah. That he rose from the grave. That he resurrected on the third day. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So the miracles that he performed, the Lord performs the miracles. Hallelujah. That they will bring him glory and bring praise to his name. You know how you know that God pulled that thing off of you? You know, that thing took place and you looked up and said, oh my God, oh my God, I know that was you. Because I didn't really do anything. Hallelujah. All I did was show up. All I did, hallelujah, glory to God, was obeyed you when you said go. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But I thank you, God, and I give you praise. I give your name glory. Hallelujah, for the miracle that you perform. He's still performing miracles. Hallelujah. God is awesome. Hallelujah. His power, hallelujah, is still working. His power is still evident in the earth. Hallelujah. Don't give up on God. Hallelujah. Where it seems like you're in, it could just be your setup for your miracle. Don't tell me God can't drop glory on that situation, hallelujah, to bring his name glory. God can drop glory on that marriage, hallelujah. God can drop his glory, hallelujah, on that rebellious child, hallelujah, to bring his name glory, hallelujah. God can turn that decision around for you, hallelujah, to bring his name glory. Amen. Everything that happens that was not intended by us could just be a setup for God to bring his name glory through his miracle working power. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So God wants us to look at this thing, hallelujah, through his very eyes. Hallelujah. Every letdown is not a letdown. It could be a setup. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He comes to let you know, hallelujah, that he still has the power. Glory to God to perform a miracle for you. So elevate your faith. Elevate your expectations beyond what you can do. Elevate your faith and your expectations beyond what man says. Elevate your expectation and your faith, hallelujah, beyond your situation, beyond your struggle. Glory to God, beyond that test, hallelujah. What did God say? What did he promise you? Glory to God, hallelujah. It's the time to just get our eyes off our situation. The enemy wants to overwhelm us. He wants to weigh us down and make us heavy and cause us to lose our faith and our trust and our belief in God. But the devil is a liar today, because God comes to say, hallelujah, glory to God, that I'm still, hallelujah, performing miracles by my power and by my spirit, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. All he wants you to do is believe. All he wants you to do, hallelujah, is put your confidence back in his miracle working power, his capabilities and his ability, hallelujah, to pull that thing off, hallelujah, for you in Jesus' name. Glory to God. He says in his word, you're not the head, you're not the tail, you're the head, hallelujah. You're not the borrower, you're the lender, hallelujah. You're not beneath, you are above. Glory to God, hallelujah. It may look like you are, but you're not, hallelujah. God's power still works today, hallelujah. Glory to God. I was reminded of a testimony regarding my brother who was hit by a car. This happened about 15 years ago. And I got a phone call saying that my brother was hit by a car. And listening to the witnesses and those that saw what had happened, I was told that he had soared maybe about 30 or 40 feet into the air. And it's just no way at the rate that he came and hit that ground that he should even be alive. My God, but God is a good God. And so at the hospital, we were told, amen, that it was some very bad damage done to his legs and to his head and certain areas in his body, some broken bones, and the doctors were even, he was immediately taken into surgery. Amen. Hallelujah. And he was in surgery for like 8 hours. My God. And so as he laid in the bed after surgery, and the Lord began to speak to me, and he said, I said, go and pray for your brother. And I went to the hospital, and upon entering that room, the Lord told me, he said, now that you're here, I want you to lay on him and begin to pray in your heavenly language, hallelujah, that the Holy Spirit would make intercession, hallelujah, for your brother. Glory to God. And as I laid there and I began to pray, glory to God, a nurse walked in the room, and the nurse heard me speaking in the heavenly language, and she began to pray and touch and agree right with me. Amen. And I'm telling you, there was some fire up in that room. The Holy Spirit of God came up in that room, and we just had a wonderful, high, anointed time in God. Amen. And I knew that the Lord had come, and he had performed a miracle for my brother. Amen. So listening to the doctor's report, we were told that he would have to have surgery every day for at least 30 days. And more than likely, he would never walk again. My God. But thanks be to God. Hallelujah. My brother only needed surgery one time. My God. Hallelujah. And not only that, when he left up out of that place, he left up out of that place walking. And he's been walking every since. Amen. But the Lord told me to go. And so what I had to do was go and show up. And I as I said before, the Lord didn't begin to speak until I entered that room. And what he said was, lay on him and pray. But I had to go and get the revelation. Amen. So as I said before, sometimes the Lord is saying go. Sometimes he's saying pray. Sometimes he's saying kneel. Sometimes he's saying call. Hallelujah. Be sensitive to the voice of God, because hallelujah, his miracle working power is working in the earth. Glory to God. Amen. Sometimes we're waiting on God, and sometimes he's waiting on us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So I thank God that even today my brother is still here with us. Hallelujah. He's still able to walk. Hallelujah. He's still able to run. Hallelujah. He's still able. Hallelujah. Glory to God. His life. He still has his life. He's still breathing. My God is so awesome. I tell you. And even the time I thought about my daughter and how she had got mixed up and entangled with the motorcycle club, and I have been seeking God and praying and asking the Lord, amen, to deliver her and to bring her out of this club, because the things that was taking place in her life, I tell you, it's unbelievable, it's unthinkable. But I tell you, even God, hallelujah, was watching over her, even while she was in the midst of the company of those motorcycle clubs. And you know, we've heard some things that goes on, amen. And I prayed and I cried out, hallelujah. And the Lord told me, he said, you know what I want you to do? I want you to take that oil, that anointed oil, as a sign. Take it over to the building where you know she's hanging out at. And you take that oil and you just put it over that door, and you decree and declare that your daughter's coming out of that motorcycle club. And I tell you, hallelujah, by the grace and the mercies of God, hallelujah, he brought her out. And when he brought her out, he brought her completely out. Amen. And today, right now, today, she's married and she has a child. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And she's living, hallelujah, a good life. She's living a life of peace. Hallelujah. She's living a life of joy and happiness. So I just thank God. Glory to God for his love and his, how we can just hear the voice of the Lord. And he tell us to go. He tell you to step out and do it. Step out and do it. Yeah, the devil tried to come and tell me, no, God didn't tell you that. You're gonna look crazy. You're gonna look like a fool. Ain't nothing gonna happen. I said, devil, you a lie. I heard him clearly. Amen. And I obeyed the Lord. Hallelujah. And I saw the hand of God moved by his power, and he brought deliverance, amen, to my daughter and to her life. And he shut the doors of that motorcycle club. He shut the doors forever. Glory to God. So we serve an awesome God. Hallelujah. When he talks about his miracle working power, that's his awesomeness. Hallelujah. When he talks about his miracle working power, that's his mighty acts. Hallelujah. Step out. Hear the voice of God. Step out and obey him. Glory to God. He is not a man that he should lie. He is not the son of man that he should repent. Glory to God. God wants to prove himself to you. God, hallelujah, wants to show you just how awesome he is. But he works in a mysterious way. You can't figure God out. You know, that's the thing about miracles. Hallelujah. You can't explain them. Hallelujah. It's unexplainable. Well, how did that happen? He will astound the witnesses. He will astound those. Hallelujah. He will astound you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So he just wants you to know that he is still able, by his power, glory to God, to perform a miracle for you. Amen. I thought about over at in Canaan, hallelujah, a village in Galilee where Jesus was invited and attended the wedding, and he went there and he turned the wine into water. And the Bible lets us know that was one of his first miracles, hallelujah, in the land of Canaan, hallelujah, and how the Lord was invited in, and he went. So God wants us to invite him into your situation, invite him in, hallelujah, to that circumstances. Talk to the Lord about it, ask him, hallelujah. I will ask God for a miracle, amen, hallelujah. Glory to God. So I say to you, amen. Be encouraged. Be encouraged of the Lord. Amen. Don't doubt God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Put your confidence in him. The Bible lets us know, don't put your confidence in the flesh. Put your confidence in the work of God and the work of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And in the work of his power. Glory to God. And until next time, I say to you, hallelujah, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. God is able. Amen.
What's going on, y'all? It's Mr. Bell. Some know me as Anton Choirboy Bell. Others know me as Elder Anton Bell. I am co-CEO of Bell Global Network, VGN TV 2090. And I want to invite you right now to get your own broadcast. Calling all ministries, all politicians, all business owners. Get your own broadcast right now. Starting at $99. And if you have an idea for a TV show, we can bring your idea to reality. We have a package that's available that includes production and facilities. Also, we have advertising packages starting at little $25. So don't hesitate. Give us a call at 313-355-7877. Once again, that's 313-355-7877 to make an appointment today.
You never ever let me down, and when I'm sinking in sin, you never ever let me drown. You're my lifeguard, my security. You took my insecurities and put me in the lion's den and took out all the fear in me and gave me a limit to undeniable faith. In your arms I'm safe, and for that I give you praise.
My soul says thank you. My soul says thank you.
What's going on, y'all? It's Mr. Bell. Some know me as Anton Choirboy Bell. Others know me as Elder Anton Bell. I am co-CEO of Bell Global Network, VGN TV 2090. And I want to invite you right now to get your own broadcast. Calling all ministries, all politicians, all business owners. Get your own broadcast right now. Starting at $99. And if you have an idea for a TV show, we can bring your idea to reality. We have a package that's available that includes production and facilities. Also, we have advertising packages starting at little $25. So don't hesitate. Give us a call at 313-355-7877. Once again, that's 313-355-7877 to make an appointment today.